Is there a part where you got stuck? And if so, describe specifically what confused you.
I got stuck in the beginning because there wasn't really a story to it.
The purpose of the math interview is to really get them using that questioning language. It really strengthens the discourse between the kids.
How did you solve the rest of the problem?
Good morning, everybody. So we're conducting our math interviews today. Before I started, I would get a lot of, well, I don't know. I don't know. I don't even know where to start. And now, before they call me over, they've either asked a peer, looked around to check the anchor charts, or they've written down something that they know about the problem. Each of you will be given one task. Either you'll be task A or you'll be task B. First 5 to 7 minutes of class, you work on your problem, I work on mine. We cannot help each other at all. But you don't have to have the right answer to conduct the math interview. So task A, write your partner's name on your paper, on the interview paper. Everyone has the document with the questions all laid out. With task A, you can begin interviewing task B. Now it starts out very scripted. The very first question is, when you read this problem, how did it make you feel? That question is rarely asked in math.
Did you understand what the problem was asking yourself?
And then you get into the nitty gritty.
How did you solve the rest of the problem? What steps did you take and why?
I had to do line equals sine method.
And so now the kids can enumerate the things that they did.
And then I had to divide.
Once you get all of those out, you get more into the like, okay, let's get into reflective questions, okay? Have you ever seen a problem like this before?
Is there a point where you get stuck?
There was a point where I didn't know if the 4 goes over the 36 or the 36 goes over the 4.
Did you give up or did you figure out a way to move forward?
I figured out a way to move forward.
You can go ahead and switch if you have already finished the first interview. After you interview me, if I didn't finish my problem, you can now help me, but only after the interview, because you want the thoughts to come out as pure as possible.
What did that step help you know or figure out?
One thing I'm really walking around listening for is, one, are they sharing their ideas?
When they gave me the 3.5, I knew from there to what to multiply.
How did you know what to do? And then obviously I'm looking for that vocabulary of math. And then we could even say, I divided the
dependent
by the independent. Are you able to articulate yourself using that math language? And also I'm just looking to see how well they are engaging each other in the interview. It's scripted and it sounds robotic at first, but after you do it so much, kids sort of internalize it. This is how I should ask a question. I shouldn't approach you and say, hey, what's your answer? That has no substance for me if I'm trying to truly learn from you. If I ask you, hey, can you explain to me how you did this? What was step number one? Why did you do that step? So it's that constant questioning.
Did you give up?
I didn't give up because I knew the steps to take and I took my time to do it and not give up.
So that's the beauty of the math interview.